Now we will go through the role of L-carnosine in different diseases. We will discuss their basic pathology. First, I would like to start with autism. And before we start with autism, we need to state some serious facts about this disorder. Autism rate increases between 6 and 15% each year. I don't know if you are aware of the fact, but we are witnessing a real epidemic of autism. Autism is severe developmental disorder with a poorly understood etiology and causes. Okay, genetics certainly plays its roles, but this rapid growth cannot be explained only by genetics. Some external environmental factors has something to do with autism. And even if, and now we don't know the exact cause of autism, and I'm sure that someone who discovers it will be the candidate for Nobel Prize. But some things in autism and some facts are well researched so far, and they are published in very important journals. Let's see what do we actually know about autism. First, lipid peroxidation markers. We now know that lipid peroxidation is oxidative degradation of lipids of the lipid membrane. So lipid peroxidation markers are increased in autism, suggesting that oxidative stress plays a large role in this disease. Also, in autism, in autistic patients, scientists found decreased levels of ceruloplasmin and transferrin. Those are those proteins that carry iron and copper in the blood. And since we don't have enough of this transferrin ceruloplasmin, that will lead to abnormal copper and iron metabolism in the brains of those affected by autism, which will eventually lead to the excessive production of free radicals and to oxidative stress. Also, levels of antioxidant enzymes, meaning superoxide dismutase, glutathione peroxidase, and catalase, are decreased in autism, suggesting that our defense system in autistic patients is not working very well. Everything of these will lead to oxidative stress in autism. And recent studies showed that L-carnosine, by inhibiting and decreasing oxidative stress, can help autistic patients in many various ways, mainly centering on the child's behavior, language skills, and enhancing nervous system system function. The parents and the patients are observing the improvement in terms of vocabulary, in language comprehension, object recognition, fine motor skills, awareness of surroundings, and responses to carnosine treatments are usually seen between 1 to 8 weeks after starting the treatment. When Carnomed first started to produce supplements, that was 6 years ago, the majority of our patients were children with some kind of developmental delay, children with different hypoxias, with different hypotonias, children with cerebral palsy, children with autism, ADHD, and so on. And what we have observed after years of experience with those children, first, they are. We are seeing improvement in terms of their focus and their concentration. So their focus and concentration are better. And the outcome you get when they are on the supplements, even if you are working with them or the speech therapist, for example, you will see improvements, maybe in a few days, maybe just in a few weeks. Just give them the time and you will for sure see the difference in their behavior. Also, we are seeing improvement in terms of socialization. Those children, when they are on the supplements, are sleeping sleeping well. They are becoming calmer, and the work with them is much easier, and you are getting better results. This everything results in their overall in their better overall well-being. Now I would like to move to the heart diseases. Heart diseases are still the major cause of death worldwide, and they're responsible for about 50% of the dead. Heart failure represents a real an enormous clinical problem, and 400,000 people are diagnosed with heart disease in the United States each year, which is a lot. And heart muscle cells, so-called myocytes, contain the largest number of mitochondria, since heart needs a lot of energy because it is pumping the blood astonishing 100,000 times per day. What is connection between L-carnosine and heart disorders? Well, healthy heart muscle naturally contain a certain amount of L-carnosine, but however, supplementation with L-carnosine improves the strength and endurance of the heart muscle by up to 30%. That's a lot. Also, L-carnosine is able to improve heart contractility mainly by regulating calcium levels. And also, L-carnosine is able to inhibit sympathetic nervous system that promotes hypertension and thus to decrease blood pressure. When we are talking about atherosclerosis, free radicals are found to be the major cause of developing atherosclerosis, and in this case oxidation is to blame, because oxidized LDL cholesterol, harmful cholesterol, is atherogenic, and it's thought to play a large role in forming atherosclerotic plaques. And also, this oxidized LDL cholesterol is cytotoxic, meaning that it is able to damage endothelial function of blood vessels. Since L-carnosine is able to prevent oxidation of LDL cholesterol, it is able to decrease its concentration in the blood and thus prevent atherosclerosis as a whole. Also, there are studies performed on the ischemic heart muscle, which found that L-carnosine is able to maintain the cardiac function with ischemic injury before, during, and after the heart attack. Actually, L-carnosine is the carnosine extra is the perfect supplement for preventing the heart attack and to speed up the process of recovery after the heart attack occurs. And here I would like to show you another paper, which is about protective effect of carnosine on adriamycin-induced oxidative heart damage in rats. Adriamycin is a drug medicine that is being used in the cancer patient, that is very common and very widely used chemotherapy, mostly on the breast cancer. One of the side effects of adriamycin is very severe cardiotoxicity, and the scientists found that L-carnosine was able to prevent this cardiotoxicity when using adriamycin, and hopefully it can be in the future can be used to decrease side effects of these drugs. Now let's move to diabetes. We all know what diabetes is. Diabetes is a disease where where we are witnessing high blood sugar levels. Exposure to chronic hyperglycemia may result to microvascular complication in the retina, in the kidneys, and in the peripheral nervous system. But do we actually know how that damage is made? To better understand connection and association between L-carnosine and diabetes, we must go through one process called glycation. Glycation is a process, chemical process, that is happening through every second throughout our body. Sorry. Even right now, while I'm talking, the molecules of sugars are attaching to my proteins. And why is this important? You may remember when I said that our health and life depends on three main factors: energy produced in the cell organelles, mitochondria, proper transmission of information through nerves, and intact protein structure. Intact protein structure is of crucial importance. We can say that intact protein structure is as equally important as energy production in the cells. Actually, we have our genetic material, our DNA, just to code and create proteins. And proteins are involved in many biological functions. Let's go through some of them. Enzymes are proteins that facilitate chemical energy. For example, we have pepsin, that is enzyme in our stomach, which help us to degrade proteins from the food. Then we have antibodies. Antibodies are proteins that are produced by our immune system and help us to fight infections. Then we have DNA-associated proteins, which are regulating the chromosome structure and expression of some genes. Then we have contractile proteins, which are involved in the muscle movement and muscle contraction. Those are actin and myosin. Then we have structural proteins, which provide a support to the body. They are found, for example, in our skin and in our blood vessels. Those are collagen and elastin. Then we have hormone as proteins. Insulin is good example of hormone proteins. Insulin is helping us to regulate uptake of glucose in the cells. And then we have transport proteins, which are helping us to carry the molecules throughout the body. Hemoglobin, for example, is carrying oxygen throughout the body. That is also the protein. And now, when we know what are the proteins in our body, we are definitely more aware of the fact how their structure and function are important. Our body is mostly made up of proteins, and this is why anything that causes protein damage can have such a significant impact on our appearance and our health. Together with free radical production and the disturbance in mitochondrial functioning, glycation is thought to be involved in the generation of many diseases today. Glycation is actually a chemical reaction where molecules of sugars are attaching to proteins following the production and creation of non-functional and damaging protein structure. This is kind of what happens when you heat, for example, sugars and they caramelize. The same thing is happening in our body. So basically, the sugar molecules are caramelizing the proteins in our body. And this destruction is a prime factor in aging process and is particularly devastating for diabetics. This destruction is not only the major factor in aging process, but in all familiar signs of the aging, for example, from the wrinkled skin, cataract, or destruction of our brain tissue. Actually, the wrinkles are just glycated collagen molecules. And this is not just a cosmetic question when you have a wrinkles. This is actually an indicator of the damage that is happening throughout your body in every other organ. People who have diabetes, in diabetes we have excess sugar molecules, and people who have diabetes have up to triple more chance to glycation damage than those who do not have diabetes. Actually, diabetes intensifies the process of glycation, and glycation is responsible for why we are getting atherosclerosis, why we get cataract, why we get peripheral nervous damage, why we get other vascular issues. Glycation is responsible for all complications caused by diabetes. L-carnosine can help patients who have diabetes because L-carnosine has chemical structure that allows it to bind with sugar groups. Otherwise, if left alone, those sugars will attach to the proteins and make those proteins unfunctional or dysfunctional. Also, L-carnosine is able to remove already glycated proteins from our body, meaning that it's able to remove that sugar from the protein and make that protein fully functional again. And the bottom line here is, the less glycation occurs in your body, the more healthier you are and the more healthier you will be. Here is just sum up about L-carnosine and diabetes. So L-carnosine prevents glycation, removes glycolase proteins, stabilizing blood sugar levels. Actually, we are witnessing in our patient that L-carnosine was able to decrease their sugar levels in the blood almost in the same way as, for example, metformin does. Also, L-carnosine prevents complications caused by diabetes, and it can regulate insulin secretion. Before we start with neurological disorders, I would like to summarize what we have learned so far. So we now know that L-carnosine shows its beneficial effect in reducing oxidative stress in autism and in cardiovascular diseases. And by prevention of glycation, L-carnosine keeps us protected from further health complications caused by diabetes. Actually, L-carnosine ensures that our proteins are staying healthy and functional.